This is a man who came up from underground with a sack of ore. And this is their jaw crusher in Kenya. And he's crushing it down. You see the gravel size that he's crushing it to. And this will go directly into the ball mill. And this is all by hand with a hammer. And then he will take it over here to the ball mill. She is putting her ore in. A couple, two or three sacks of ore go in the ball mill. Over here, this is where the ore comes up damp and they dry the ore on these tarps because it needs to be dry to go in the ball mill. This woman over here, I think, is drying her ore. And they may wait two or three days to run their material. And the women have a little pit over here. This woman's carrying a small child on her back. So these women are not allowed to go underground. And so they have to scavenge the dump piles on the surface. And they're working together. And they put it in these sacks. And then they will take it over to the ball mill to crush it. And then sluice it. So the women really scavenge what they can from the surface. Just started up his ball mill. And here is his clutch, right here. Tightens up the belt and engages the ball mill. So that's how they start and stop the ball mill with that stick as their clutch.
It's a little hot.
Hot, I bet, yeah. He wants it finer. They're gonna run more.
Good.
Oh, I see. So he's putting a screen on so the balls stay in. And he has a wedge. And this guy is his oar. And the guy in the green shirt is the operator. And he's going to go and engage the clutch and disengage it so it falls around and drops oar out the bottom. That's how they empty the ball now. This is the material that comes out the bottom of the ball mill. It does a pretty good job of crushing, maybe 20 mesh minus, a few bigger pieces.
So currently what they do after it comes out of the ball mill, they take it over to one of their locally made sluices, like this woman is using right here, and they wash the material with a bucket down the sluice, which looks like it has nothing more than carpet in the bottom. No riffles, no expanded metal, and they are losing a large amount of gold. You can see the tailings piled up around them. So we are going to rerun all the tailings on the shaker table and recover more gold. Thank you.